So in this video, we're going to learn how to find a particular solution of an inhomogeneous equation when the right-hand side is a sine or a cosine function. There are two different methods of doing this. The method in this video is the more straightforward approach, but maybe requires a little bit more algebra. The method in the next video is more sophisticated, but is maybe easier to do. So the main key here to find some function x that satisfies this equation, we need an ansatz. As in the case of the exponential function, we can try a constant times sine t. The problem with that is that the first derivative will give us a cosine t. So we can't just guess sine t, we have to guess a sine and a cosine. So the ansatz here is to try x equals some function times, say, cosine t plus some other function times sine t. So what's important here is that we match the argument of sine t. So if it was sine 2t, we would guess A cosine 2t plus B sine 2t. Okay, we take our ansatz and we substitute into the differential equation. So we take the second derivative of this. Remember, cosine t becomes minus cosine t, sine t becomes minus sine t. So second derivative becomes minus A cosine t minus B sine t, and then minus 3 times the first derivative. So the derivative of cosine t is minus sine t. The derivative of sine t is cosine t. So we have a minus 3 times a times a minus sine t. So that will be plus 3a sine t. And then we have a minus 3 times a b cosine t. And finally, minus 4 times x. So minus 4a cosine t minus 4b sine t. So that's kind of the lengthy expression from substituting in. And that's supposed to be equal to 2 sine t. Okay? The next step of the algebra is to collect all the terms multiplying cosine and all the terms multiplying sine. So let's do that. See if I can do that in my head here. So the terms multiplying cosine, we have a minus a cosine sine sine cosine minus a. We have a minus 4a, so minus 5a minus 3b. So 5a plus 3b, so negative 5a plus 3b times cosine t. And the terms multiplying sine, we have a minus b sine t, minus 4b sine t, and we have a 3a sine t. So 3a minus 5b plus 3a minus 5b sine t. And that's supposed to be equal to 2 sine t. Okay. When you have a constant times a cosine plus a constant times a sine equals a constant times a cosine plus a constant times a sine, you can equate the constants multiplying the cosine, and you can equate the constants multiplying the sine. You can see that by putting t equals 0 here. So then if sine 0 is 0, cosine 0 is 1, so we get 5a plus 3b has to be 0. right? Or the term multiplying the cosine equals 0 times the term multiplying the cosine on the right-hand side. We also get, if you put t equal to pi over 2, then cosine pi over 2 is 0, sine pi over 2 is 1, we would get 3a minus 5b equals 2. Okay? So you can always do that. The term multiplying the cosine, the constant multiplying the cosine on the left is equal to the constant multiplying the cosine on the right. The constant multiplying the sine on the left is equal to the constant multiplying the sine on the right. That gives us two linear equations for the two unknowns a and b. We can solve that. How should we do that? I think we can eliminate b. So if we to eliminate b, we can multiply, say, this first equation by 5 and multiply this second equation by 3, right? And then we add them, the b will go away. So we'll get 25a, 25 plus 9 times a equal to 5 times 0 is 0, and 3 times 2 equals 6. So this is 34a equals 6. Or if we divide through by 2, we get a equals 3 over 17. Right? 17 is half of 34. My arithmetic is not always perfect. And then we can figure out what b is. So maybe from the first equation. So b is equal to minus 5 over 3a. So that will work out. The 3 will cancel. So we'll have minus 5 over 17. Right? Okay. So we found a and b. So we have our solution. So I can write down the solution here then. So we have our x of t is equal to a times cosine t plus b times sine t. I can factor out the 1 over 17. And then we have a 3 cosine t and then a b sine t, so a minus 5 sine t. Okay? Hopefully that's the correct answer. So let's review then how to find a particular solution when the right-hand side is a sine function or a cosine function. Because it's a second order equation that contains the second derivative, first derivative, and the function, we can't just match sine with sine. We have to try an ansatz that contains both a cosine term and a sine term. But we always have to match the argument of sine in the ansatz. Then you substitute in, you do a lot of algebra, you collect terms, and then you set the left-hand side equal to the left-hand side multiplying cosine equal to whatever is multiplying cosine on the right-hand side. The left-hand side multiplying sine, whatever is multiplying sine on the right-hand side. That gives you two equations and two unknowns, which you then have to solve. In the next video, I'll show you another technique, which is actually the technique I prefer. And hopefully you will prefer it also. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.